Football is a 20th century technological struggle.
And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture.
Football has hitting, clipping, spearing, blocking, punting, late hitting, unnecessary roughness, and personal fouls.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again. Here we are on Stanley County, Monday Night Football. Charles Kersey of the Stanley News and Press alongside my friend Mr. Brian Carter of Carter Video Services. We're here again tonight at West Stanley High School. Boy, is it windy tonight. Temperature has dropped. We've had rain all day. We may have a little more later. Hopefully not. We see West Stanley warming up behind us. They're 2-1. They lost last week 21-7 to Albemarle. They were held to negative 24 yards rushing. After rushing for 477 yards their first two games, Josh Wilson had a bunch of catches last week, five catches, 103 yards, and that touchdown. And all week, I talked to Coach Johnson, and they were talking about getting Christian Boone more settled into his starting quarterback position. North Stanley was off last week. They're 1-1 right now. Actually, they're actually walking off the field as we speak. After their warm-up period, they were 1-1 overall. They've had two quarterbacks that have been sort of sharing snaps, but according to Coach Jackson, tonight one will be a starter and one will be a backup. Noah Crisco has 13 of 24-yard completions in passing, 186 yards, two touchdowns. Matt Price, 5 of 10 for 47 yards passing. So one will be a starting and one will be the quarterback. I mean, one will be the backup quarterback. And Antonio Williams has 213 rushing yards and two touchdowns. We'll be back with the head coaches on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with West Stanley head coach James Johnson. Coach, let's talk a little bit quickly about last week. 21-7 loss to Albemarle. But really, your team was really solid for most of the game.
I thought we played really well defensively, and guys did a really good job learning what Albemarle wanted to do. And other than one busted coverage, which led to the first touchdown, I thought we played a very good game defensively. Could have tackled a little better. Probably the best job we've done all year, taking on blocks with our block destruction. And one of the better jobs we've done of understanding what the opponent wanted to get accomplished. Offensively just didn't block very well. And some of that's credit to their defensive scheme and their defensive line. Not that there was anything they hadn't shown, but we just didn't handle the pressure and them the ability they have to get off the ball quickly up front very well. And then some mistakes in the backfield, too, with balls on the ground, bad reads, not just by the quarterback, but by the running backs fitting and in the scheme. And when you play like that offensively, it's going to be tough to win.
Talk a little bit about your focus in practice this week. I know we talked briefly about trying to make your quarterback feel a little more comfortable out there.
Mm-hmm. He's gotten a lot better this week. Hopefully it'll show up in the game. Games are always a different animal, especially, a kind of rivalry game like this. But he's just a young kid. He did baseball in the spring and didn't get a lot of reps. And splitting time with two or three guys in the summer did not get a lot of reps. So there's things that are new to him each week. And something I've got to do as a coach is make sure I'm teaching him those things. And kind of take for granted. You feel like, well, I taught those quarterbacks all that stuff. Well, he wasn't there a lot of the time. And that goes back to me making sure that he's comfortable, he understands the things we're seeing. And I thought we adjusted and we really hadn't practiced a lot of our screen game stuff much in the week last week. And we adjusted and had a couple things in the game off of it. The touchdown pass, which the inside receiver ran the wrong route. But so it was more covered than it should have been. But that was something Ethan Morgan actually at halftime, he said, hey, let's pump it and go instead of running, our other scheme off of it. And so we went and did it, and, it opened right up. And the inside receiver kind of ran a guy there, but it still worked out in the end. So he handled some things, and I thought he made some strides during the game. And he's just got to be confident. When he makes a mistake, realize that everybody on that field is going to make mistakes. Your coaching staff's going to make mistakes. The refs are going to make mistakes. The linemen, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Everybody's going to make mistakes. It's how you react to it and how you proceed through the rest of the game.
How do you feel like West Stanley and North Stanley match up on the field?
It's going to be interesting. I think both teams have quality running backs. So that'll be really, you know, really interesting to watch. You know, some you know, I mean, really, the county's got a lot of good backs in it, and you know, Malik, and then Antonio and Lacey on their side, and you know, Blaine and Cameron Brown will probably see more touches tonight than he has this year. We've been using him more at fullback, but we're kind of shifting some things around a little bit. And Cameron's pretty good with the ball in his hands, and you know, moving some guys here and there a little bit to try to get a little better offensive production. And you know, so we got to be able to block them up front better than we blocked up front last week. And you know, I hope our linemen will be up to that challenge.
Coach, thank you very much for your time and best of luck tonight. We'll be back with North Stanley head coach Ralph Jackson. We're back here on the pregame show on Stanley County Monday Night Football with North Stanley head coach Ralph Jackson. Coach, let's talk a little bit. We talked this week about how the bye week came a little early for y'all, but still came at a really good time for your team.
Yeah, it gave us a chance to get back to the basics with the bye week. You know, we had a lot of competition drills with the guys, and I think the guys got a chance to actually relax and actually, you know, to get a little more comfortable, to be honest with you.
We've talked about the two quarterbacks that you guys have been using. Do you have one that you're going to go with tonight?
That's a game-time decision, to be honest with you. I mean, both of those guys bring something totally different to the table. Both of them are great guys that work hard. I mean, you know, great leaders. Yeah. So whichever one we decide to go with tonight, they'll know right before the game.
I know you've gotten a chance to see West Stanley on film. What has impressed you about the Colts?
Well, they play hard football. You know, I seen the game last week. I was here in person. And I was just truly impressed with how hard they played for those four quarters. Defensively, they fly around the ball, make some plays. Offensively, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. You know, that's the old West Stanley way anyway, to be honest with you. And they do it well.
As you would know well, of course, from back in the day.
I may know something about that a little bit. Yes, sir.
It must always be fun for you, you know, to come back, to bring your comments over to West Stanley because of the time that you spent here playing at West.
It is. I mean, you know, it's really an exhilarating opportunity for me and the guys. You know, last week the guys came here, you know, they were at the concession stand talking about, Coach, your name's on the top. I said, guys, that was 20 years ago, man. You know, right now we're trying to get you guys where you need to be, basically.
How do you feel like these two teams match up, and what are the keys to a victory for North Stanley?
I think it's going to be a very competitive game. For us to win this game, we have to play assignment football. We have to play for four quarters and play mistake-free.
Coach, thank you very much for your time. Best of luck tonight.
Thank you, sir.
We'll be back with the kickoff on Stanley County Monday Night Football. This is going to be great. Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Stanley County Monday Night Football. Charles Curcio from the Stanley News and Press alongside Mr. Brian Carter of Carter Video Services as we are about to bring you North Stanley and West Stanley tonight here at the West Stanley High School Football Stadium. North Stanley has won the toss. They will defer their choice to the second half, so West Stanley will receive to start this game.
You know, I noticed most teams this year, you know, they defer to the other side.
But I know a lot of teams like to do that when they, because that's when you make your adjustments, is in the
interesting strategy in the
halftime locker room, and you want to come out, you want to be able to start the second half outright. North Stanley 1-1 on the season.
opened with a 26-24 win over Central Academy, and then lost to Randleman 31-10. West Stanley started out with wins over Northwest Cabarrus. And then a win against South Stanley before their loss last week, right here on Monday Night Football to Albemarle. Here come the West Stanley Colts.
They seem enthusiastic.
Well, they're playing with a lot of confidence. Even after last week's tough loss to Albemarle, they still played very well. Here come the North Stanley Comets, 1-1. It's going to be a loud, raucous game tonight, I guarantee you that.
Yeah, this is the third round battle for the Stanley Cup, isn't it, Charles?
Absolutely, and West Stanley, 1-1, would like to have one more win, and then they would need a little help then, because having lost Albemarle, Albemarle would have to lose their games to South Stanley and North Stanley in order to win the Stanley Cup. We're experiencing some audio difficulties. Fans, if you will, just stay with us for a few minutes. We're trying to work it out right now as we speak.
Just a little technical difficulty.
Number 7, Tyler Billingsley, my fault, will be kicking off for North Stanley. And 33, Malik Jackson, and number 6, Blaine Long, are the deep men.
We called their names a lot last week, didn't we?
Always a good battle between these two teams. West Stanley has won 31, North Stanley 20. They've tied twice. Here we go. This kick is going to curl out of bounds, and it is going to come out on a penalty to the 30. It was out of bounds to the 22, but I believe it'll come out to the 35. Possibly the 40, I'm not 100% sure. Or they may choose to re-kick. And it looks like West Stanley may be choosing to have this one re-kicked. And that's exactly what's happening. The kickoff unit for West Stanley is back on the field.
I guess we'll redo this one.
So they'll back him up 5 yards, I believe, and they'll kick it over. Again, like I was saying, the all-time series is 30. West Stanley leads the all-time series, 30 wins, 21 losses, and one tie. West Stanley had won, I believe it was several in a row, 5 or 6, but North Stanley has won the last two.
Can you hear me okay? Okay, gotcha. Yeah, and the Colts' last win over North Stanley was in 2011. It scores 2014.
It was a 20-14 win. That was at North, I believe. So 5 yards for kicking it out of bounds, and Billingsley will kick it again. This time it's a high end-over-end kick, going to be taken by Long at the 12. 20, 25, puts his head down across the 30, down to the 32.
Blaine Long, number 6, brings it up over the 30, about the 33-yard line. West Stanley offense is taking the field.
So, of course, we're used to we've seen the offense of West Stanley now. Saw them last week, of course. They love those direct snaps. Right now, Christian Boone is in at quarterback. From the pistol formation, he'll give to Malik Jackson. Jackson across the 35, down around the 37, give him about 4.
Straight ahead, taking the hand up 33, Malik Jackson. He's across the 35-yard line, to about the 38-yard line. Maybe 5, we're told second down. Second and 6, gain of 4.
It'll be 2nd and 6 now at about the 37.
Malik
West Stanley getting the play in from the sideline. Same formation with three wide receivers and one running back with sort of an H-back. The H-back is 44, Shane Cole. Boone's going to throw. He's got a man open. It's Josh Wilson. He's got it. 40 and down to the 36. Wilson just, I'm sorry, go ahead. Wilson just sat down in the coverage and did a great job there. And a great tackle. But it moves the chains down to the North Stanley 36.
And that was Adrian Brown in on the tackle.
So a gain of 28 yards on the pass. It was a great play. Did you see how Wilson kind of sat down in the middle of that zone? He got sort of to the second level of defense and then just sat down right there. Jackson now across the 35, down to the 32. Number 30, Mike Peoples on the tackle that time.
Peoples making the stop. Ball's on about the 32-yard line. Gain of 4, second down and 6.
So good West Stanley drive early. We've got 10:20 left in this opening quarter.
At the 31-yard line.
Colts have already driven about 40 yards. Oh, Jackson never had the football, and I believe he lost it. He did. Number 22 on the recovery is Nick Chandler.
I had a pretty good shot of that, Charles, but I couldn't tell you who recovered.
It was 22, Nick Chandler, I believe. It was just, it was never, he never really got a handle of the football. It looked like there was a problem on the exchange. And the Comets will take over at the 33. The possession changes hands with 10 minutes and 1 second left in this first quarter. And it's going to be Matt Price, the starting quarterback. He gives to 34 Antonio Williams. And Williams, not much room, maybe 2 yards on the play.
Yeah, not much of a surprise there, Antonio Williams. They got to use some other weapons instead of Antonio.
Going to bring up second down and 8. From the I formation this time, Williams cuts up the middle over the 40, down to the 41. Going to set up a third and short, third and about 2. Well, they're going to see a steady diet of Antonio Williams. There's no doubt about it.
Third down and 1.
So going to be a third down and short, third and about 1. Going to be a toss sweep this time to Williams. Still on his feet. Got a first down. We'll get across the 45, down to the 48.
That carry is over the 45, about the 47-yard line. Williams on the carry. It's going to be a first down for the Comets.
So 3 straight carries, and Antonio Williams delivers a first down at the 48.
Morgan back there making that stop.
Three wide receivers this time, 2 to the near side, 1 to the far side.
Let's see what the passing game looks like.
It's going to be Lacey Riggins, and Riggins around the right side's got some room. 45, look at his moves, down to the 41 of the Colts. He's got terrific moves.
Well, that's what, you know, we can't forget about Riggins. That's the other weapon.
He's down close to the 40-yard line.
They're going to mark it around the 41. It looks like it should be good enough for a first down.
They're going to call a timeout. Looks like
they're going to have to bring in the chains.
We have a timeout on the field.
They're going to stop momentarily to measure this one. Just from my own eyeball, it looks like it's the ball is resting inside the 40, almost like 41 and a half. There's no yard lines, but that's just an estimation. And the first down marker sitting at about the 42, so this should be a first down, I would say, fairly easily.
Let's see if we got it zoomed in.
Depending on the spot. And he has the first down by the length of the football. An 11-yard run for Lacey Riggins, by my count. You know, that Lacey Riggins may be the one guy on the North Stanley team that you really care. You know, everybody knows about Antonio Williams. Obviously, he's a Division I recruit. But Lacey Riggins has the ability to be just as dangerous. He has that breakaway speed.
5'10", 180 pounds.
Tyler Reynolds is the lone wide receiver to the near side. A hard count this time. And something between either 75 moving on North Stanley's side or 70 jumped the line. And we'll see for West. Either Tyler Honeycutt was offsides or 75 Chad Dennis drew him off. That's what the discussion. North Stanley is backing up like it's a false start. And that's exactly what they're going to call.
Well, they'll back him up foul.
To be a 5-yard false start against North Stanley. First down and 15.
So that's two penalties already against North Stanley for 10 yards. Now facing first and 15. Riggins again off the right side. A penalty marker immediately flies. Riggins, there's a battle. There's a couple of battles going on the line there. Riggins is down at the 43, but let's see what the penalty is. And it's against North Stanley. I didn't see what the call was. The illegal procedure.
That was Connor Edwards in on the time.
The penalty is declined. It'll be bring up second down.
And we have 7:37 left in the first quarter.
Interesting. Second down and about 14. Fakes one way, now gives to Williams. Williams got a good block in front of him. 40, 35, look out, still on his feet. And down around the 32. He's going to be short of the first down, but what a tremendous play.
About the 33-yard line.
Well, Williams is off to a good start.
So he's third down in one.
You get third down and about one. The ball resting at the 32. Third and one now. Williams cuts inside. He's got a first down. North Stanley is putting a nice drive together just between the tackles. And Williams is doing much of the work.
And I can't wait to get the stats on Williams here.
Williams on that play.
As soon as I get a chance, I will take a look at that.
Ball's inside 25, 22-yard line. That'll be a first down.
So far, he's performing solidly.
He has 34 yards on five carries. He's averaging 6.8 yards per, which will do the trick. First and 10 now. I formation, three wide receivers once again. Bryce back to throw. He's got man-on-man coverage in the near side. It's incomplete. The pass was out of bounds. Really wouldn't have been caught in the bounds. It was number 8, Tyler Reynolds. And I believe that was Malik Jackson. It was down there with him step for step. We're going to bring up second down.
Unfortunately, threw into my blind corner here.
Well, the ball went out of bounds, so even if he had caught it, he was out of bounds at the time.
So we didn't miss anything.
Clock has stopped now. 6:12 left, opening quarter. Comets on a 4-minute drive now. Going to fake one way, now give to Williams. Williams tripped up at the 20. Gain of about four.
This is down about the 21-yard line. Got to be
I tell you, Williams is already having a good night already. didn't get shots from the Colts faithful for defense.
Third down and six now. Same three wide formation. Price looking at the near sideline, and it's incomplete. His wide receiver, Grayson Lunsford, never turned around. You couldn't tell if it was intended for Lunsford or for Tyler Reynolds that time. It'll bring up fourth down. It would be a 37-yard field goal attempt from where they're at right now.
How do you predict they'll probably go for this one?
The Colt Crazies all over the North Stanley starting quarterback, Matt Price. He started for West Stanley last year, probably why. Williams on fourth down, puts his head down, he's got a first down and more inside the 10, down to the 8.
Brand new set of downs for North Stanley Colts.
Comets.
North Stanley Comets, I'm sorry.
You went to school there, you should be able to get that. First and goal now for North Stanley. 5:23 left, opening quarter, no score. This was the Comets' first drive and recovered a fumble and have marched down the field now. It'll be a toss sweep to Williams. He cuts it inside. He's got plenty of room and he's in. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets. Well blocked to the left side. And there was a 5-minute drive, so with 4 minutes and 59 seconds left.
Where's the smoke coming from, Charles, from the North Stanley side of the field?
You have a good point. I have no idea.
That's an odd one. We'll maybe find out later.
We'll definitely check on it. Billingsley's kick is up and good. 4:59 left, opening quarter. North Stanley 7, West Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 11 plays, 67 yards. Drive for the Comets. It's a short kick. We got penalty markers before the kickoff. And we'll see what's
may have to do this over, folks.
Going on about that. As we mentioned just briefly, North Stanley starting quarterback Matt Price played last year at West Stanley, so there's a little subplot for that going on. But
well, you see how I got the North Stanley Colts confused, you know?
that's why you did it. Yeah, it has nothing to do with the fact of it's 90 degrees up here, probably. So another penalty against North Stanley on the kickoff will knock him back 5. We'll kick this one again.
And North Stanley's on the board first, 7-0, 4:59 to go in the first.
This time an end-over-end kick going to be taken by Malik Jackson, going backwards at about the 13, 20, 25, gets lined up by North Stanley's number 30, Mike Peoples, right at the 30. So it'll be first down for West Stanley right at the 30. Colts had a good first drive, drove 40 yards down the field, but a problem on the exchange between Christian Boone and Malik Jackson led to a fumble, and the Comets took that ball and then took the 11 plays in 5 minutes to score. Jackson this time over the right side, maybe a couple of yards. Get a good spot. Actually, it'll be marking about the 33. Brings up second down and 7. West Stanley is taking their time. You see, both teams really want to control the tempo and the line of scrimmage in this game. Boone now is looking close. Now he's looking for Blaine Long. And Blaine Long is just separated from the football.
by number 12.
Adrian Brown with a terrific play, and Blaine Long is getting up a little slowly.
That was a major league hit right there.
That was a big old hit.
And on the sidelines, well, if you can see the monitor, he's trying to shake that off.
Yeah, I see that. So it's going to bring up third down and seven now. Long is now out of the game. Three wide receivers this time, one H-back, looking for that same play as same throw, this time complete to Ethan Morgan. Morgan's got a first down. They basically ran the same play twice.
Yeah, Adrian on the tackle again, number 12. Adrian Brown.
This time the gain is to the 46, and it's a first down. The 13-yard, it's a 12-yard gain, but the thing is, Brian, they ran that same play twice. It's sort of an option pass, because basically what's happening is you've got two wide receivers. One's lining up short. The other one is just going in between, you know, going about 10 yards down the field, and they've been open several times so far. Malik's looking for some room on the right side. A penalty marker comes in late. He's going to get about 3 yards, but let's check the penalty. It's in the area.
Well, guess who's in
holding.
Guess who's in on the tackle again?
Adrian Brown. Adrian's from the other side of the field.
I mean, he's all over the place.
We've already gotten the call that it is holding. Yep, it's holding against Wes Stanley. It's going to be a 10-yard penalty.
It'll be coming back.
Mark off 10 yards on that.
First penalty of the game against Wes Stanley. It'll be marked from the Colt 45 to the 35. So it'll bring up first and about 20. Effectively losing 13 yards. You lose the 3 yards. And because it's a spot foul, the foul happened 3 yards behind the run. This time, running that same pass play, another penalty marker comes in. Boone runs out of time. Gets sacked by, it looked like, I believe, 77 Austin Parker and 51 Jacob Pratty.
He was definitely in trouble.
And it was holding, but the holding penalty was declined.
North Stanley defense looking sharp tonight, Charles.
Well, Wes Stanley was moving the football well on their first drive. Not the case here. It's going to be second down at about 23 now. Jackson is back in for Cameron Brown at running back. Brown was in for one play there. Ethan Morgan will come in motion. Boone fakes the give, then keeps it, and is wrapped up nicely by Nick Chandler. And actually lost another yard to the 31.
Yeah, let's give it up to North Stanley defense.
And Wes Stanley is going to call timeout, and we'll take a quick one as well. 2:46 left, opening quarter. Wes Stanley trailing North Stanley 7-0. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Third and 24 for Wes Stanley. Colts now throwing over the middle, incomplete.
Oh, almost intercepted by Adrian Brown.
Pass was intended for 24, Justin Balcom, and it's going to be a punting situation.
Yeah, we keep calling Adrian Brown's number here.
He's a heck of a defensive player.
Yeah.
He's only 5'9", 150 pounds, but really is tremendous. Of course, we remember his brother, Trey Brown. Tremendous athlete as well. This punt is off the side of the foot and goes out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. So Logan Green's punt, not a particularly long one, and it gives the Comets the ball. They'll give him at the 40-yard line, only a 9-yard net punt. So with 2 minutes and 34 seconds left, opening quarter, second drive of the game for North Stanley, and they've got tremendous, tremendous field position.
You know, they definitely have the advantage here.
Williams gets a nice block up front, 40, 35, look out, makes a move, 25, and down to the 22. Running with a lot of confidence. 18-yard gain that time. That'll be a first down. North Stanley is coming out very quickly offensively in this game and making a statement. Grayson Lunsford and 24 Riley Smith are the wide receivers to the far side. Now Lunsford comes to the near slot. Going to be Williams again, trying to make a couple of moves.
Gains about 3 or 4 yards.
Ethan Morgan was leading the charge there. He was just trying to stay in his lane there.
Well, that's all West Stanley can do right this moment to contain Williams.
Gain of about 3 or 4. Well, make it 3. It'll be second down and 6. Make it 2nd and 7, I'd rather. Clock now, minute 35 left, opening quarter. Comets inside the West Stanley red zone. Going to be another toss sweep, this time to Lacey Riggins. Got a nice block out front by Lunsford. But, oh, boy, is he hit hard at the 15, maybe up to the 14.
I think that was number 64, West Stanley.
64 West Stanley, that's the senior D lineman, Tyler Eford. They're going to mark it at the 15. That brings up third down and about 3. Chant of defense from the Colt Crazies. Elijah Clark is lined up at fullback for North. Price now looking to swing it to Riggins, and it's incomplete. Actually, a little fortunate that that wasn't called a lateral, because the way the ball bounced, Wes Stanley would have had could have taken that ball and just run with it.
No, absolutely. And we got 36.7 seconds to go first quarter.
And it looks like North Stanley will again go for it on fourth down. Fourth and about 4. West has got 7 in the box to try to stop the run. They'll fake to the fullback. Now get to Williams. He's right behind his blockers. He's got a first down across the 10, down to the 8.
Looks like he's inside the 10.
I'll give him a new set of downs here.
Well, they'll actually mark that one at the 6. First and goal for North Stanley at the 6. 20 seconds left in this quarter. They'll probably get about one more play in, barring the clock stopping on an incomplete pass. Williams off the right side. He's in. Touchdown, North Stanley Comets.
Touchdown number 2 for Williams.
There is a penalty marker down, though. Let's see. It's on the far sideline. Looks like
it's coming back.
Illegal formation against North Stanley. Mark the ball back to the 11. Fourth penalty, I believe, so far on North Stanley. Clock has stopped. This will be the last play of the first quarter. 2.9 seconds left. Tosses it to Williams. 3, 4 Colts all over him. Just followed him that time, and he loses 4 yards.
Well, he lost his foot in there.
So we've reached the end of the first quarter with a score. North Stanley 7, West Stanley nothing. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football.
Today on Focus on SCC, we'll look at Stanley Community College's Associate Degree Nursing Program and what it can offer you. Annie Ruth Kelly Associate Degree Nursing Program teaches students the skills and strategies to bring safety and quality into nursing care, to practice in a dynamic environment, and to meet individual needs that impact health and quality of life. Graduates of this program will be able to take the National Council Licensure Examination, also known as NCLEX, and the employment opportunities are vast within the global healthcare system.
Students should take the nursing program here at Stanley because it's a two-year program that's going to offer them a lifetime of careers in healthcare, whether it be in the hospital, home setting, really anywhere they might want to pursue a healthcare career.
I love helping other people. It's something I've always wanted to do my whole life. And once I got my kids raised, I decided it was time to go back to school. I chose nursing to have a good career choice, and there'll always be a job for me.
Students should expect to work very hard. They're 2 years here. They're going to have lots of clinicals. They're going to have class time. People always dread the test because it is a new way of thinking. However, when they graduate, they'll be expected to pass their NCLEX, which is from the Board of Nursing, and they'll be prepared to do that.
We've had rotations on the med-surg floor, on the cardiac floor, and then to our local nursing home. Our program incorporates clinical hours and class time hours. We get a variety of exposure throughout our 2 years here.
We prepare our students here at Stanley Community College to take care of all types of populations, whether it be OB, pediatric, adult settings, in all sorts of fields, and they should be able to be an entry-level RN and feel comfortable and confident to provide safe, effective care to their population.
For more information about this or any other program at Stanley Community College, visit us on the web at stanley.edu, stop by the Eagles One Stop, or call us at 704-991-0123.
We're back with the second quarter on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Second down and goal from the 15-yard line.
What, isn't it great having the scoreboard back?
Like you don't know. Price back to pass. Looks like he's going to swing it to Williams. It's incomplete. Just trying to be too careful on it. And it's going to bring up
enough juice on it.
Third down.
Well, the only thing not working with the clock is the down. But we can live with that.
I can take care of that myself. Yeah. The other, especially the time, is the most important thing.
If nothing else.
Critical play here, third and goal from the 15. Comets going to give to Williams. Williams trying to make some room. He will not. I think that was Cameron Brown that actually led the charge that time. So he gains about 4 yards. This may be a field goal attempt. I see Billingsley.
I was about to ask you, Charles.
Coming onto the field. Tyler Billingsley's got a good leg. And it looks like it's going to be fourth down. It's going to be a field goal attempt. They'll mark this at the 18, so it's a 28-yard field goal attempt.
Well, let's see how their kicking game looks here.
Snap is down, kick is up. He may have gotten that one. It's good. 11 minutes, 4 seconds left. Billingsley with a 28-yard field goal. We'll be back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Back on Stanley County Monday Night Football, a short kick of, oh, wow. Hello. That's a shot at the 41. When you have those short kickoffs, it's just absolute danger and pandemonium. It'll give the Colts decent field position at the 41. I realize the reason you don't want to give your other team the chance to return it, but if you've got somebody that can kick it deep, especially kick it into get touchbacks, I don't understand the short kicking game myself. So a 27-yard field goal by Tyler Billingsley. Comets lead now 10-0. And Malik Jackson gets the carry down to around the 46 or 47. Give him 6 yards, and I'll make it 2nd and 4. Jackson now has 5 carries, but 16 yards.
Jackson, one of his more stellar nights so far, but let's see how he comes out of this.
Well, for the most part, North Stanley really hasn't given him a chance to break loose. And we saw Jackson, you know, had some big nights, and I know that his counterpart, Antonio Williams, has to be taking personally the fact that Jackson leads him in yards. But now Williams has 13 carries, 89 yards, and a touchdown. Third down this time, and he's got the first down. He leans forward, didn't have it initially. When he first, you know, it's yards after contact, and he got a yak there that he needed for the first down.
He took advantage of that.
We're waiting on the spot right now. They're going to move the chains and give him a first down at the Comet 49.
And last stop in the American 30, Mike Peeple.
.918 clock running in this second quarter. Jackson now trying to bounce the outside. 45, 40, 35, still on his feet, down to the 32. Riding, two guys riding him down. Nick Chandler and Bonnie Brewer. Or check that, I'm sorry, 21 is Taylor Chandler and Nick Chandler. But a good run by Malik Jackson. And the Colts sophomore is giving West another first down at the 32 for a first down. A 17-yard gain that time.
Nice job, Mr. Jackson.
Colts trailing 10-0, 9 minutes left in this first half. So they give to Jackson once again. And you could see North Stanley just trying to strip that football out of there. But they'll give Jackson 5 on that play. And it'll bring up 2nd and 5. And you can see West Stanley has they got some yardage early through the air, but now trying to utilize the ground game.
Well, that's just been very successful for them so far here.
Christian Boone has 40 yards passing on 2 of 4. Jackson, oh, baby, is he hit hard that time. And not much, maybe 2 yards.
Yeah, I think at this point that they're keying in on Jackson. They need to spread it around a little bit.
Actually, I believe that might have been 34, Cameron Brown. Brown only got about a yard. Now third down. Oh, ball is loose, and North Stanley looks like they have it.
Turnover on that play.
Oh, Let's see what the official says. And they,
do. It's number 30 on the recovery. It's Mike Peoples.
We have an injured player here. We're not quite sure who
and
it
it's
is. Right
it's
now.
The man who recovered the fumble. It's Mike Peoples. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to contradict you, but I did.
I did
see who it was. Yeah. Or excuse me, that's 30, Mike Peoples. That might be 33. That's down. We'll check
that
and see.
That would be Trey Keeble. That's 33.
I think it was 30. I'm still going to stick with who I originally thought it was. We're going to take a quick timeout while we have this injury. We'll be right back. Back on Stanley County, Monday Night Football, first and 10 from the 25 for North. Williams over the 30 to about the 31 for a gain of 6. He has certainly been the workhorse tonight for the Comets. Comets have run the ball 17 times. He's run it 14 for 95 yards. He's averaging 6.8 yards a carry. You have to average 5 and 6 yards a carry. That's going to move the chains, and that's what's happened on the first two drives. Even though the Comets had a penalty and then stalled in the red zone.
Well, that shows an efficient ground game.
Williams now some nice moves, first down. I like the way Antonio runs. He's always looking to break one, but I think he also has the wherewithal, Brian, to figure out when he has enough and maybe all that he actually needs, and then he gets that's all he needs, and he goes down.
Yeah, just you know, doing
he
his
gets,
job.
He gets what he needs. First and 10 for the Comets now from the 38. 6:41 left, first half. Comets lead 10-0. Price is going to throw, and this time it's complete for a first down and more. Oh, he fumbled the football. Are they going to rule him down? They are not. It's West Stanley football. The first completion of the game, that was to Tyler Reynolds, but Reynolds fumbled the football.
It's number 56.
And you said 56 on the recovery.
Mm-hmm. Eric Honeycutt.
So the senior defensive lineman coming back. And a quick change of possession, 6:28 left in the second quarter. 10-0, North Stanley's ahead.
Well, that's a momentum changer.
Certainly is. Boone barks out the signals on first and 10. Jackson, 50. And down to 48, and the referee takes a tumble. And on the other side of the field, what you didn't see was a battle between, I think that was C.J. Harris, 65, and I didn't catch the West player. Might have been Eric Honeycutt. We're having their own little personal tussle.
Yeah, the referee took a bit of a dive there, but they're tough guys.
So you want to be a referee, huh? So Jackson carries it to the North 48. It's going to bring up second down and 4, a 6-yard gain that time. Izaguirre gets the ball on the jet sweep, tries to cut inside, and North Stanley is just waiting for him. I think that's Chandler once again, and 65, C.J. Harris. That was Nick Chandler, the senior. No gain of the play, maybe even lost a yard. They're going to mark actually a loss back to the 49, and it brings up third down and 5.
5:25 to go in this first half.
West Stanley has all three of their timeouts left. Boone now. Look at Terrence Anir. Sideline. That it is. Nothing. I was waiting because there was a battle going on between Issaquir and number 23, Monty Brewer. And of course, guess who was in the neighborhood? Adrian Brown. And it'll bring up fourth down.
That's no surprise during this game.
There is a penalty marker down. Let's see what this is. Let's see what this is.
We're having a bit of a discussion.
If it's an incompletion, it's interesting that if North Stanley takes this penalty, personal foul. Against West Stanley.
That should back them up 15.
That's 15. That'll mark them back. From the penalty, it'll be marked from the West Stanley 45, but they will be declined. So they'll decline the penalty. I thought for a second they might take it, but it doesn't seem like.
Now, what's your thinking on that?
I would not take the penalty. Because it's fourth down, you want them to try to have to punt. Because if they give up the football, if they don't make it on first down, then you've got the ball in really good field goal, in field field position at your own 45, somewhere near the middle of the field. Logan Green puts this one in the air. It's a much better punt this time. Takes a comet bounce right at the 20. So Comets will have the ball with 5:04 left in the first half.
Looks like the first one down there in the 35, Harrison Flow.
Just looking at some individual stats quickly. Malik Jackson has 10 carries for 48 yards. As a team, West Stanley 15 carries, but just 45 yards. For North Stanley, 18 carries, 119 yards.
Wow.
Williams, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 7 different Colts.
He was trying that spin move. It just didn't work. There was too many Colts around him.
He's actually going to lose several. Actually, he's going to gain a yard. Excuse me, it'll bring up second down. It'll bring up second down and about 9. One of the few times we've actually seen Antonio tackled for less than 7 or 6 more yards. One of the few times at least. Price is going to throw. He's going to swing it complete to Williams. Williams bounces the outside. Puts his head down and gets to the 25. I love to watch the way he finishes a run.
I know, that effort at the end, you know, pushing forward.
No, but who does he remind you of, the way he finishes a play? He reminds me, and you know, these comparisons like this are difficult to make, but he reminds me of a Walter Payton. Walter Payton, you know, Sweetness was always the one. You know, he finished runs viciously. I mean, he was not, you know, a shrinking violet when you tackled him. He'd put his head down and knock your socks off.
Yeah. I was about to say maybe Barry Sanders.
Barry would just make you miss, though. Yeah. Walter would run you over.
Well, that's true.
Lacey Riggins, no gain this time on third down. Cameron Brown led the charge that time along with Eric Honeycutt. And this is going to be a punting situation. No gain on the play. They're starting to key on Williams, and obviously he has had a tremendous first half. Blaine Long is back in after he took a wallop earlier. He didn't miss too much, though, but it's good to see him back on the field. You don't want to see anybody hurt in these games. Big old C.J. Harris, all 260 pounds of him, is the punter. This one's off the side of his foot, and it's a bad punt. Goes right towards to Coach Jackson, standing at the 35. It's only a 10-yard punt. So West Stanley gets a wonderful, wonderful field position.
Well, let's see if they can take advantage of that.
With plenty of time left, all three timeouts at 2:42 left. Absolutely. There's only about five offensive players out on the field right now.
They better
and finally, here comes Boone and Ethan Morgan and Izaguirre and 81, the talented Josh Wilson. Wilson has impressed me very much this year so far in the games we've seen. Passes over the middle, and it's complete to the 20. It's Izaguirre, still on his feet, down to the 18.
Looked like, Brian,
I thought there was some confusion on North Stanley's coverage because there were two receivers right on top of each other, and it kind of worked in West's favor.
Yeah.
And the ball will be marked at the 19. It's a 16-yard gain. And a late touchdown here. And now North Stanley is going to call timeout. And we'll take one as well with 2:29 left. Second quarter, 10-0 North. West Stanley's driving deep. We're back on Stanley County Monday Night Football. 2:29 left, second quarter. Comets lead the Colts 10-0. Colts first and 10 now at the North 19. Jackson once again, look at him get behind his blocker, still on his feet.
Winds
up in the hands of C.J. Harris.
Say C.J. was fighting for that ball.
Jackson will get 4 yards on the play. It'll bring up second down at 6. Clock running now. 2 minutes left. West Stanley doesn't have to worry about time considering their field position. That bad punt by C.J. Harris has really set up West Stanley to possibly get some momentum back in this game with some late points in this first half. Nice fake by time by Boone. He faked out several North players, I think. And Jackson gets a first down at the 9.
Yeah, it was a good fake. It faked me out.
It's a good art form. You know, that takes some effort. You know,
a lot of good timing and sleight of hand, almost like a magician.
Well, you know, your good quarterbacks do that. They're able to hand off the football, and you really don't know if they still have it or not. Oh, fumble on the play, never exchanged it.
And
North Stanley's got it.
And on the recovery, let's see.
51 by, it looks like. Yes, it is. 51 is the recovery. That's Jacob Craddy, the senior D lineman.
Mr. Craddy, I know him.
So on the botched exchange, another turnovers are just killing West Stanley. A minute 23 left. North has two timeouts, but probably, considering their field position, aren't going to be in a huge hurry. I try to see what they can just do with a couple of running plays. Instead, they'll go to the air. Price out in trouble, and he is sacked. He goes down at the 8-yard line. Number 70 on the sack, I believe that was Tyler Honeycutt.
Let's see, what would be your strategy right now, Charles?
Well,
I mean, you've got 56 seconds left in half, and you're pinned back deep. I mean,
let's put it this way: if I were West Stanley, I'd call my timeouts. I would have called one there.
Not doing.
Clock is running under 45 seconds now. I would call three timeouts. I'd call one after this one if they don't make it. Williams around the right side. Look out. 20, 25, 30. He's putting on the speed. Got two men to beat. Fakes one out. Tries to fake a second out. It's Blaine Long. Blaine Long slows him up just enough. Antonio Williams all the way down to the West Stanley 24-yard line.
I think that'll make our highlight reel.
That would make anybody's highlight reel. And now North Stanley might want to call a timeout just to try to regroup a little bit.
Yeah.
It's a 67-yard run, and that's exactly what North will do.
I cannot wait to hear the stats.
Their second timeout, and I'll tabulate those stats right after this. seconds left, second quarter. North Stanley with a big 68-yard run. Williams will get his stats in a second. Price back to throw, looking towards the end zone. He's got a man open. It's Adrian Brown. He's got a touchdown. North Stanley Comets.
Beautiful, beautiful throw by Price.
He just got behind the coverage and just beat him to the ball.
And we're calling Brown's name again.
So Price has a touchdown pass to the speedy Adrian Brown from 24 yards out with 21.6 seconds left.
Yeah, let's see if this PAT is good.
Billingsley for the point after snaps a little high, but the kick is up. That kick is good. 21.6 left, second quarter. North Stanley 17, West Stanley nothing. We'll be right back. Big momentum change in late in this second quarter. West Stanley was driving deep. Problem with the exchange down to the 10-yard line. North Stanley drives 90 yards in just a couple of three, four plays, and finished off with a touchdown pass from Matt Price to Adrian Brown. Another short kickoff this time. Going to be taken at the 40 and returned to the 43.
Brought up to about the 42. That ball was taken. Taken number 24, Justin Balcom.
I think it was Justin Balcom that actually returned that. I couldn't see the number.
18.4 seconds to go.
West Stanley has all three of their timeouts. But 18.4 seconds left. Let's see how risky the Colts play this. Boone now throwing long. He's got a man down there, and it's complete. 425-20. It's guess who? Josh Wilson once again down to the 12.
Mr. Wilson.
Once again, just when you need a big play, who do you go to? You go to number 81.
And I'm sorry, folks. Perfect, I was in my blind spot.
That's all right. A perfect pass from Christian Boone to Wilson. He wants to call timeout. The ball's going to be marked at the Comet 13.
Christian Boone, Josh Wilson, big game on the play. Ball's about the 13-yard line.
That's a 45-yard gain. West Stanley now will call their first. Oh, North will call timeout.
With 9.8 seconds left.
North Stanley calls timeout.
And we'll take a break.
Be right back. 9.8 seconds left. West Stanley trying to get some momentum back on their side. A huge pass, 45 yards. And yeah. North Stanley was actually charged with a timeout, maybe trying to set their defense, I'm assuming. Boone back to throw again, going to the near side. Oh. This is picked off. It is picked off by Adrian Brown, and he'll return it to the 23. And now the Comets can run out the clock in this first half and go to the locker room up 17 to nothing. What a play by Adrian Brown. Christian Boone never saw him.
I was tracking his helmet
the whole time. He was looking right at his receiver, yep. And that's what you're taught as a linebacker and a DB. Watch the quarterback's eyes, and that's exactly what he did, and he jumped the route.
That was about as good as it gets.
So he intercepted that ball at about the, I'd say about the 8-yard line, returns it to the 22.
Yeah, I guess we'll take a kneel down on this call.
Well, there's four wide receivers in.
I guess we're saying why not?
Lacey Riggins will come in motion. They fake one way. Now give to Lacey Riggins. Riggins has got some room. Oh, and he trips up. And a penalty marker comes in at the 35.
I think he might have hurt his ankle on that one.
And he is down, you're right. Quickly picked up by his teammates, but if it's an offensive penalty, it's over. It is holding against North Stanley to be declined. That is the end of the first half. We'll be back with the halftime festivities and stats with the score, North Stanley 17, West Stanley nothing, on Stanley County Monday Night Football.
Don't go anywhere.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, on Stanley County Monday Night Football. Let's take a quick listen to the North Stanley High School marching Comets.
Mm-hmm.
ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome to the field the Marching Colts of West Stanley High School.
Proud to present your West Stanley High School Marching Colts. Thank you.